that last-second defeat to Fiji.
So pride on the line, fifth place semifinal up for grabs. Here they come. France and South Africa going to battle it out here at the HSBC Canada Sevens. There is South Africa, of course, a hotly contested quarterfinal. They lost that to Samoa, 28 points to 17. Quite a tough pull for them to get through. That may be part of the reason. And there's a united French side put up perhaps one of their best performances of the season, taking Fiji right to the death, but losing out 24 points to 21. And we heard the piece on the referees, how there's so many international people getting involved. Great to have Tavita Rokavarini, the Fijian, on the whistle for this one. Well, Madison, you played here, and Sunday in Vancouver is a little bit special. The energy really builds.
Vancouver's a fantastic tournament. All the players love to play. I think with the roof closed, you just get that energy contained, and it's a lot of fun.
Well, let the fun begin. France in the blue jerseys kicking off to South Africa, not 10. So the early mistake from Mazzolini, that's actually how they ended the quarterfinal, when he threw the ball into touch when they were threatening against Fiji. Well, we heard from Coach Neil Powell in the break, and we know how clinical they are. They'll be a little bit disappointed with some of their execution this weekend. This is a chance to set it right. On the ball there, Ronald Brown getting the start here. And that man's been exceptional all weekend. The bigger of the Davids, Zane Davids. Brown skiving across the face of the defense. Finally gets back infield. Real width. Chikso Iswapi's got his hands on it, but he's also got two Frenchmen on him. Have they caught the French this time? The leading pass. Beautifully weighted pass to Ronald Brown. And what a difference that makes, Madison Hughes. When the ball's in front of you, you can run onto it.
Absolutely. I mean, Ronald Brown was hugging that touchline, standing right next to it. And South Africa, clinical, well-executed passes, able to get across. The French defense had got narrow. And so Brown able to stroll over in the corner and dot it down for the first try of this match. South Africa not having to do too much, not complicated, some hard carries, but just maintaining the width. And that's something that everyone really tries to drill into rugby teams from youth onwards. See, the touchline conversion is fantastically done from Brown. So 7 points for Ronald Brown right at the start of this game.
Yeah, good start for South Africa. Ronald Brown, only his fifth tournament, but knows how to get it done. Coming through with that piece we saw before the game with Neil Powell, there is this subplot. South Africa done incredibly well in Canada over the years, actually the current champions after the 21 series. And they're also playing for him. He's moving on to the 15s game after this to try another challenge. And, you know, that must be weighing on them a bit, this man who's done so much for them. And the French are going to be penalized here for not putting their man on the ground immediately.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Fenner Powell, he's had such success with this team, really bred in a good culture and consistency over the years. And the Sevens World Cup in South Africa will be a fantastic way for him to sign off. Once you've got the man in the air, you're allowed to have like a second up there, but the French just pushing that too far.
I like the quote from his piece, integrity is doing the right thing when nobody's watching. I think that sums up the hard work ethic of this Blitzbacher side. Now powering to the 22, it's JC Pretorius. He epitomizes that work ethic. South Africa in explosive mood right now. The offload wasn't necessary. I think he may have been in. Grobelaars picked it up. But he's knocked it on. Okay.
Come down.
The referee's going to have a chat.
I think one of the French players. Yes.
Blue. 11 blue. Yeah. Deliberate knock on.
Maybe a yellow card.
Okay. 11 blue.
And that is Joaquim Trubal they're looking for. And he's going to send 2 minutes in the bin.
Yeah, so Selvin Davids, as he's going across the field, just waiting for him, for Trubal to look in field. Once he does, and that pass, we can see it go off his hand, go forward, and there's been no sympathy for that. It's an instant yellow card, and it's been like that all weekend.
Six Frenchmen to defend the line. Seven Blitzbachers form the attack. They go to that same corner that provided group. So Zlati is the benefactor this time. Another wonderful leading pass puts him into the corner.
French once again defending very, very narrowly, and that gives the touchline to Soyuzwapi. I think saying, okay, if you're able to complete four passes, you're going to be able to score in the corner. And for a team like South Africa, whose skills are at that level, it's too easy for them.
Wonderful look at the legwork. Soyuzwapi, the captain, vastly experienced in his 36th World Series event. Part of the Olympic team that went to Tokyo. Great individual as well and highly competitive. Two tries for him last week in Singapore as well.
Yeah, fantastic physical player who's really taken on that South African wing position after Sabela Sanatla and really jumped up and scored so many tries here in Canada. Loves to play in Vancouver, obviously.
Just an update if you tuned in yesterday. Perry Baker had a bit of an injury, but he seems to be well. I know, Madison, you had a little note from him, so reassurance that he's up back to himself.
Yeah, he just said he got his head in a position he didn't really want it to. It was a scary one. He was down for a little bit, but texted me that he's okay and looking forward to, I think, at this point getting home.
Well, great to hear, and I'm sure he's looking forward to the rest of the season, especially the Rugby World Cup coming to South Africa, Cape Town in September. The overthrow is in the hands of South Africans, and ominously that left corner is looming again. Sarzapi's going to take it, and he does. Three tries, and it's an expensive time in the tin bin for Gourbav.
French really haven't been in this one at all so far.
In 2004,
against Fiji, I think, must have taken a lot out of them, and it's been all too easy for South Africa. They've just kind of spun it across the field three times and have had three tries from that. Soyuzwapi gets the fend out. Brushes off defenders, and he is a powerful runner like that, but the French, they'll be disappointed with how easily South Africa is scoring.
Just a great shot of the fend off that was right in the shoulder blade, which as a defender just kills your ability to wrap.
Absolutely, I mean, the accuracy of where you're fending the opposition player and at what moment you're contacting them is so, so important, and the best players just instinctively time that so that the players are not able to get their hands on them.
And once again, ruthlessly, not that he hasn't had practice from that sideline, Ronald Brown adds the extra 2 points. 19-0 for South Africa over France at the moment. The low flat kick gathered effectively by France this time. Really their first touch in attack. And they're back to full strength. The loping stride of the big man, Simon Jarisse. He gets them going. Oh, offering up on a short line.
Knock on.
Was over. Frenchman didn't get the ball. Advantage over. Off they go again. Van Vick spinning. Short ball. So Zwapi's brought down. He's trying to get rid of it because there's no support there. This is good interplay from the South Africans. Just one of those teams that's constantly asking questions of the defense, never allowing the men in blue to get comfortable. More space out wide. Kovalar stepping inside. As soon as he got that defender turned, his shoulders turned, he just set him up and beat him off the right foot.
Yeah, Kovalar, I think just seeing out of the corner of his eye that there was no third French defender, so the two were sliding across the field, and so he knew if he beat this French defender on the inside, there was going to be no one else to go. Van Vake slipping and sliding out of the tackles, moving the ball across the field. Of course, it came from the turnover that South Africa created, and that's what they do. France made the line break. South Africa, they hunt in numbers, they force the turnover, and it gets them into good attacking positions.
Well, that'll do it at the half. It's been all Blitzbock. South Africa with four tries, three conversions, and 26 points on the board. 26-0, South Africa over France. So for their efforts. There's the restart again, the low flat one, beautifully executed. Well, that's about as well as you can draw it up on the whiteboard of the training session, although France have counter-rucked. Not quite sure what the call is against 10. That is Joris.
Yeah, I think maybe coming in from the side of the angle the referee didn't like, but that's unlucky. France committing numbers to the breakdown, trying to force that turnover. And that's what you want to see. Hasn't gone their way so far. At the beginning of the second half, they need to make something happen, especially with their defense.
South Africa working. So Zwapi, oh, look at that. Just outstanding.
Release now, footwork. 10. Thank you.
His knee's on the ground, so he has to be released. Flat ball. Grobler out wide. He gets dumped. It's this balance of the physical nature and the skill when the Blitzbach are playing their best. So he's going in for a hat trick. That's three for Shakes in Vancouver.
So Zwapi once again the recipient. Ronald Brown with a nice miss pass over the top. Looked like Marius Damore realized that he might have knocked that on if he got it. This was earlier. So Zwapi step, getting across, forcing more French defenders to come in. This was the long pass. Ronald Brown looking up, throwing it over the top, and I think Damore realized that if he left his hand there, he was going to knock it on. So good realization. Didn't want to knock it on and have France having to spend another 2 minutes with six players.
Conversions pulled wide.
And it's been all South Africa in this match. I really think France threw absolutely everything they had at Fiji. And it is a testament to some of these teams at the very top of the standings. They have that depth where they can continue to absorb injuries like we've seen South Africa do.
So Zwapi joining your old teammate Baker at the top of the Vancouver try list. Of course, South Africa are currently top of the HSBC World Series standings. And
time
with
off.
New Zealand and Samoa and Fiji
off.
Appearing. And Australia slowly working their way up. So much to play for left on the series here. And there are the French. Top six spot for them. But look at New Zealand down there in 15, ominously with Fiji and Samoa climbing up.
Yeah, I think all those teams will be having one eye on those teams. How quickly can they climb up the table? South Africa, I mean, absolutely peerless. There was about a 35-36 game winning streak they had. They've stumbled these last 2 weeks. It hasn't gone the way they'll have wanted. So I think they'll go back to their training camp, evaluate what's happening in this tour, and look for them once we get those European legs to be really coming back strong.
London and Toulouse to come in May.
Knock on.
That's been knocked on and picked up by a man in front of him. So a penalty. Quick tap. Look at that urgency. That sums them up to a T, and they're all immediately on the plan. Pretorius doing his work. Davids carries, but he may have bobbled it forward.
We're going to penalize you. You're taking up space. Him.
Taking up space. It's a tough one to avoid, perhaps, Madison.
Yeah, it didn't look to me like he was interfering with the South African player from being able to carry it away, but maybe into impeded entry. We couldn't see from that angle. I mean, we look at that.
Thank you.
South Africa, 44 passes, five line breaks, and the French with just the one pass. So France haven't had the ball, they haven't retained the ball, and they've just given it away whenever they did get it.
Here we go, a beautiful in and out step. Oh, a cheeky maneuver to get the try.
Cheeky indeed, South Africa over again. They've loved the left touchline in this game. France, they're tired, I think. They're collapsing inwards, making sure South Africa can't score up the middle, but only too easy out on the outside.
Grasping at anything, he got a bit of short, but it wasn't enough to stop the big man.
Keeping that leg drive, the crowd love it. Murphy showing a bit more than he might have wanted.
Well, can I dare say it's a cracking try?
Got any more puns there, Gareth?
Well, it's relentless. Doesn't matter how they go across the line. The Blitzbach are in control here.
High tackle, four green. Yeah, here's the mark.
You heard it. High tackle. Nothing tolerated above the shoulder line.
Decision time for the French. I think they'll know that they're not going to come back in this one, so it might be better off just kind of gradually getting to the line, taking some time off the clock, and they really need to have some possession.
Uragua giving it the quick tap. A little bit of indecision there. And not surprisingly, they're driven backwards. Christy Grobelaar continuing to do the graft, the big hard hits on the ball.
Release.
Again, and now they're trying to hold him up. I think the physical presence to this Blitzbox side is sometimes deceptive because they are so good in the open field. Oh, lining up for the big hit was Impey Visser. Nice offload from the French there. Oh, again, another blindside hit as well to keep his feet. Guillaume Boucher in space. He hits the face man. He's been quiet in this one. But Aaron Gondidier just nudged into touch.
Fantastic cover defense from Sullivan Davids. He's not the biggest man, but he's fast. And he just tracks him down, you see, using exactly. He knows where the try line is. He knows how much territory he can give up. And then once the French attacker is in that position where he cannot cut back on his inside, Davids just hunts him down and tackles him into touch.
Well, if you're putting together a coaching video on how to make a cover tackle, I think that's David's just executing to perfection.
Absolutely, getting his angles right and chasing down when he needed to.
Line out, absolutely no movement, but 100% possession. And now they're just going to nudge it downfield, just over a minute to play. This may actually be an opportunity for France to build something. Urago is back, he needs some teammates. Off and running. Jordan Seffo coming off the bench. Maybe not the finish to the weekend he wants, but he's just reminding everyone of his absolute presence and his danger on a sevens rugby pitch.
Seffo's been quiet this weekend, I'd say, by the standards he's set this season, which have been incredibly high. Sullivan Davids, he just made the covering tackle on the other side. His defense asked him to do it again. Couldn't quite get it done that time. Seffo did a good job. He came off the touchline. That means that he can use his body weight to get into Davids. On the previous one, the French attacker was just continuing to run towards that line. Sullivan Davids gave it his best attempt, but Seffo, I mean, he's strong, he's powerful. He's been so good all season long, and once again, another glimpse into what he can do there.
Dying seconds here of the fifth place semi-final. That's a shocker. It's not content, and South Africa have the chance to continue the onslaught or maybe just get it off the park. They will be playing in the fifth place final, South Africa. Who will they play next? New Zealand and England still to come. Well, a great performance from the Blitzbocker. 36 points to 7, a victory over France. Handshakes to some tired bodies out there. That'll be it for the French. But the Blitzbock will go on for one more here in Vancouver. Such respect for these players, Madison. You know you've been on the circuit as exhausted as you.